Now, with these slides, yes, I could give you all of the height dimensions and all of that. It's really not gonna matter to a point, maybe for bedding plants, but I started with the awesome spike because everybody knows about a spike that goes in those wonderful hanging baskets right in the center. They just fill out so amazingly. So me being the different person I am, I found a red spike instead of a green spike because this one was more appealing to me than the traditional flower that everybody else has. So this is going to add color. When we're talking thrillers, we're talking about this is what gives us our height. One thing that in your hanging baskets with the every planter that has a spike in it, a lot of times the spike goes all the way to the top of the hanger, right? And they kind of bend down because there's really not enough room with the hanger for the spike to grow. And then also, when you have these containers with a spike and three other plants, you know, that's a lot of competition for the spike to get the nutrients it needs when you fertilize it. Also, area. This spike will get a lot bigger if I actually give it room to grow. I was not able to actually get rubrum grass at the stores yet. If you want to pass this around, you can. So I got something a little bit different that I could find. This doesn't get quite as tall as rubrum grass. What's really nice about rubrum grass is you're not going to put this in a hanging basket. They also have one out there called Cherry Sparkle, which is variegated with a pink tip on it that's becoming very popular. But you're gonna use the rubrum grass in something in a larger container like this, a 20-inch size container. I can't imagine this in a hanging basket. This is just not gonna work very well with flowers in it. We have a lot of foliage plants for our fillers. And so when I did this PowerPoint, then I went on the hunt for all of these plants in some shape or form. And this one is called Juncus. The one I will refer to in there is an older variety called Curly Whirly. This is called Twister. So this one will get about 18 to 20 inches tall. What's really nice is when you put this in the container, it will grow, and even if you have taller plants like petunias or begonias, these little curly whirlies will stick out the plant. They just add a different effect to it as well. This can also go in full shade. So it can go anywhere from full sun to full shade, and this can stay a little bit on the wetter side as well. Okay, so another thriller. And sometimes in some of my combinations and recipes, I will be using this as a filler as well. But most of the time it's used as a thriller. This is called Angelonia. It's blue, pink, or white most of the time. The early cultivars of this had a really nice fragrance. Angelonia without the sunlight has been a little bit slower to grow in some of our nurseries. So if this is a plant you want, and you go to a nursery, you may need to ask them where this one is located. But what's really nice is this will gain a lot more height. It'll get anywhere from 16 to 20 inches tall if it is happy. So again, if we are talking hanging basket size, your hanger's not gonna be that tall. It's basically just gonna go to the roof where the hanger is and flop over. So I wouldn't consider this a great hanging basket facet or plant. But this is excellent for any containers, and it's also an excellent bedding plant and fills in really, it goes wide about 12 inches. The elephant ears, I put the black one up here. There are different green varieties. There are also varieties out there that have really bright red stems. They're really creating a lot of new varieties. You can get one with huge ears on them or smaller ears. I didn't bring one with me today. What's also nice is you can purchase these as a bulb. So buy the bulb, put it in the planter when you get the other annuals, and then let it come up on its own. They need a lot more heat. So sometimes in May around Mother's Day, we don't always have the heat to go with the plant. So sometimes it's better to put the bulb in, and then by the time June and July come, the plant will be, they'll be beautiful out there for you. And that's when we have the heat of the year. This one, we're gonna talk about salvia. And I kind of clumped all of the salvias together. I found an awesome new salvia out there. And this one is called Velocity Blue. Remember the old Victorian Blue? That is still out there. It's an excellent variety as well. That is one variety that you can probably find in self packs. This does great as a bedding plant or in a container. But what I really stuck out to me about this Velocity Blue is the blooms. Yeah. Look how thick they are for an annual bloom. That's what I fell in love with. The stem even has a blue tint to it at the very top. That's something a little bit different for the new salvias. This one is another thriller that will give you some height as well. You also have the traditional red salvia, like the lady in red. But you also need to know that it comes in burgundy, it comes in like a salmon color, and it comes in a white. Excellent bedding plant. These are also excellent fillers if you need a filler in a container, so they can be used as a thriller or a filler. And then lastly, we have our black and blue salvia. Our black and blue salvia gets a lot of height to it. It can go up to 18 inches plus in height. What's really nice about the black and blue salvia is it does have a thicker leaf and thicker foliage to it. And hummingbirds are in love with that one, and it's a butterfly attractor. So it's a really good pollinator. I would say this one, I see a lot of pollinators on. This one is called King Tut. And so King Tut will get about 2.5, 3 foot tall, especially if it's super heavy. And this is Little Tut, and it gets about 18 inches tall. And I did find Little Tut and Large King Tut is out there in the marketplace. It is super cute. I like it because it's airy. Remember how I told you I like the pet plants? I just like the texture. I like the feel. It's going to add dynamic to your container, but it's not going to be overwhelming either. I love coleus. And the reason I love coleus is because a lot of their new varieties of coleus can go full sun to full shade. They can be an excellent thriller. In a container this size, I've had coleus get almost as tall as I have, and it broke in a windstorm. So I had very happy coleus. I've had coleus get as large as this container.
One plant.
One plant. Depending on your variety of coleus that you choose. Now, a lot of your coleus that you find in your four packs, that's going to be your shade coleus. If you have a chartreuse color coleus, like I have right here, this one is called Chartreuse Street. And you do not want to put chartreuse coleus in the full sun because they will burn. They can handle so much if they're at cooled, but chartreuse coleus prefer a little bit more shade. So morning, sun, afternoon shade is what I would recommend for this. This will glow in the dark. Remember, not literally, but it's one of those bright things that, you know, with a little bit of moonlight out there, it's really going to stick out at night if you look out on that patio. Put it with them whites.
Put it with them whites.
And I couldn't just buy one coleus. I know they all look the same, like this one's French Quarter, and this one is Ruby Road. These are sun coleus. The more sun you put these coleuses in, the brighter the color you're going to have. The more shade you put these coleuses in, the duller or the faded the colors will look. So if you have, you know, a coleus that's going to get morning sun, afternoon shade, they're still going to have a pretty bright color to them. They can grow very large. A lot of these new sun poliases can also tolerate our soils. They do excellent in the landscape beds. Mine get as big as small shrubs when I put them in my landscape bed. I can put them one right in front of my boxwoods, and they get as big as my boxwood. So mine get about 2 foot wide.
Do you dead end them?
Yes, because I do not like the blooms. So that's the thing with coleus. They do get blooms. They are excellent blooms for pollinators. But if you don't like the blooms, you can cut them off.
But you don't have to.
You don't have to. The more you cut off the blooms, the more energy it's going to put back into the plant, the bigger coleus you have. This one is called Henna. This one's called Inferno. And I got one more. And this one is called Campfire. And I was placing them out and I'm like, these look very, very close together. What's the difference? The leaves. So when I pass these around, I'm gonna pass these two around together because this has a wider leaf and a more ruffled look. And then also, if you look at the new growth on the newer leaves in here, it's more of a burgundy orange color. And then this outside fades to a lighter rust. This is called Coleus Calm. And what's really neat about the Calm Coleus series is once the leaves actually grow and mature and you give this plant enough space to grow, you probably only need one plant in a 12-inch container. The leaves get as big as my hand. So when I fan out my hand, the leaves are one leaf is way bigger than my hand. So this is a very large coleus with large leaves, but their stems and their leaves are very compacted on the stem. Okay, so this is Osteus ferrum, and this will get about 6 to 12 inches tall. This is a bright orange color. It also comes in white, yellow, purple. There's also a purple called Flying Saucers, which has a different type of blue. But what's nice about this one is that they have vibrant colors. And they're much easier to take care of than a Gerber daisy. But you must deadhead. It's another deadhead plant. I did not purchase any caladium, but what's really nice about caladium is it's another one of those bulbs, and it is excellent for shade. So if you want to add mass color in shade or have something tall, the colors on a lot of our new caladiums are so outstanding, and they look really good with a lot of impatiens or begonias, and they will really just pop for you. You can go ahead and buy some caladiums that's already growing. That way you know exactly what color it is if you don't want to purchase the bulbs. And then you can store those bulbs year after year after year, so that's a way to save money with caladiums anyway. So this is Megilla perilla, and I haven't found it out there yet. I think I overlooked it when I was nursery shopping. Megilla perilla looks exactly like a coleus, but the Megilla perillas can get really, really large. I've had a Megilla perilla get about 3.5 foot tall in the ground, and I could not wrap my arms around it. We had a windstorm, and it broke all of my coleus, but it's okay if we get a windstorm and it breaks it off because the coleus will usually rejuvenate itself. Megilla perilla is very pink with a darkish black inside, but if you put it in full shade, it's actually green around the edge with a white stripe. And this thriller is called Butterfly Margaret Daisy, and this variety is Beauty Yellow. Now, this will get some height to it. It'll get about 20 to 24 inches tall, so I would not put this in a hanging basket or anything like that. This is one that you also need to stay on top of deadheading. Yes, this is a deadheading plant. So make sure that when the blooms finish, in order to keep the plant rejuvenating and blooming, that you snip off the blooms. Make sure that you take the bloom all the way back to the stem. Just don't take the flower off and leave the stem at the top. Make sure you go all the way down to where the stem meets the plant.